Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Nila Minhadila and here I would like to explain the article of Rob Waring about extensive reading in English teaching. There will be three contents that we will discuss in this PPT. The first is what is the article about, and also we are going to talk about extensive reading and the relationship between innovation and creativity in English language teaching. The first is the aim of this article. According to the article that I have read, the aim is to identify the concept or the idea of extensive reading in English teaching. So after this, we will discuss from the general information to the specific information of the text. Before it, I want to ask you, did you know what is extensive reading? Yeah, extensive reading is an approach in English language teaching which focus on establish the learner's fluency in reading text, and in this case the students will be able to read a lot of text according to their needs or their interests. It means that the learners can choose what types of book that they want to read. So when the learners read extensively, they read very easy and enjoyable with the text. And also, it can help them to build their reading speed and fluency. There are some benefits of extensive reading. The first is extensive reading builds vocabulary. It means that when the learners read a lot of text, they will meet 1,000 words or pattern that are not tough in the text, and also it can help them to increase their vocabulary knowledge when reading extensively. The other benefits is extensive reading helps learners to read quickly and enjoyable with the text. Why like this? Because the students are allowed to choose what the text that they want to read. So they will encourage to read for pleasure and become better readers. It's like when you read comic or novels that you like, you will feel enjoy and very easy when reading the text, right? And the last is extensive reading helps learners to build reading speed and reading fluency. Because of the focus of the learners is just to select the general information of the text, of course, the fluency of reading will be different when the learners focus on the specific information of the text. And then, the differences between intensive reading and extensive reading. Why I put this information in my PPT? Because we are often here intensive and extensive reading, so let me discuss it in my PPT. In intensive reading, the focus of the learner is to develop reading skill, vocabulary knowledge, and grammatical aspect. While in extensive reading, the learner focus on reading fluency. So they will develop their fluency when reading text, although bordering the mistake or others. And then in intensive reading, the learners will read short texts or books like a short story or a blog and others. While in extensive reading, the learners will read long texts or a books like newspaper, comics, and others. And in intensive reading, all of the students will learn same material because of the material are selected by the teacher. While in extensive reading, every student will learn different material because of the students can select their own material according to their needs. And in this slide is the main discussion of our topic is about the relationship between innovation and creativity in English language teaching. Before the teacher implemented extensive reading in their classroom, most of the teacher teach reading text intensively. In this case, the students allowed to read a short text like a blog, short stories, and report, which focus on developing the language knowledge or pattern, and discrete reading skill as language work in reading text. And the result of this activity is the texts are often difficult, and the reading fluency is typically slow and often requires dictionary use. While in extensive reading, the students are enabled to read a lot of text according to their needs and their interests, which focus on the general information of the text. And the main aim of the extensive reading is to build the learner fluency of reading text. So, what is creativity in this article? Yeah, creativity in this article is the concept or the idea of creating extensive reading to be a program in the classroom or in the school. So how the innovation of this article? Yeah, the innovation in this article is the realization of concept or idea of extensive reading to be a program in the classroom or in the school. So the program of extensive reading is the innovation of this article. The author in this article, Rob Waring, also explained how to set up an extensive reading and how to introduce it to the learners, because of some programs that have been running have not run smoothly because of inadequate planning and implementation. So before the teacher implemented extensive reading in their classroom, the teacher should creating the goals or aims to prepare the extensive reading program, and also the teacher should make sure that everyone involved in the activity and how to introduce the extensive reading program to the students. The first, the teacher can introduce it by ask the students to take a book from home before the learning begin. And the key points in this activity is the material should be easy because of this is the first book that they will learn. And the teacher will set up a discussion about the books, focusing on the contents. When the teacher introduces it, the learners should know why extensive reading is important and convey this message to the learners, because the learners can know the benefits of doing extensive reading. And the conclusion is, the innovation of extensive reading made a good language program which can develop the student reading fluency, and also the students can increase their vocabulary knowledge. Moreover, the researcher also give information how to create and how to running this program effectively, so the learners in the end of the program can improve their reading proficiency and other language skill, but also they can enable to take pleasure in reading text. Okay, I think enough for the explanation of the article of Rob Waring. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.